Morning. Today I, Dr. Vanna Ranga, would like to discuss what is a MOS diode. The metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, that is MOSFET, is composed of a MOS diode and two PN junctions placed immediately adjacent to the MOS diode. Since its first demonstration is 1960, the MOSFET has developed quickly and has become the most important device for advanced integrated circuits such as microprocessors and semiconductor memories. This is because the MOSFET consumes very low power and has a high yield of working devices. Of particular importance is the fact that MOSFET can be readily scaled down and will take up less space than a bipolar transistor using the same design rule. Specifically, we cover the following topics: the inversion condition and threshold voltage of a MOS diode, basic characteristics of a MOSFET, MOSFET scaling and its associated short channel effects, low power complementary MOS logic circuit, MOS memory structures, related devices including charge coupled device, silicon on insulated device and power MOSFET. The MOS diode. We now discuss what is a MOS diode. The MOS diode is of paramount importance in semiconductor device physics because the device is extremely useful in the study of semiconductor surfaces. In practical application, the MOS diode is the heart of MOSFET, the most important device for advanced integrated circuits. The MOS diode can also be used as a storage capacitor in integrated circuits, and it forms the basic building block for charge coupled devices, CCD. In this section, we consider its characteristics in ideal case. Then we extend our consideration to include the effect of metal semiconductor work function difference, interface traps and oxide charges. The ideal MOS diode. A perspective view of an ideal MOS diode is shown over here in this diagram. The cross-section of the device is shown where D is the thickness of the diode and V is the applied voltage on the metal field plate. Throughout this section, we use the convention that voltage V is positive when the metal plate is positively biased with respect to the ohmic contact and V is the negative when the metal plate is negatively biased with respect to the ohmic contact. The energy band diagram of an ideal P-type semiconductor MOS at V is equal to 0 is shown in this diagram. The work function is the energy difference between the Fermi level and the vacuum level, Q phi m for metal and Q phi s for semiconductor. Also shown are the electron affinity Q chi, which is the energy difference between the conduction band edge and the vacuum level in the semiconductor, and Q psi b, which is the energy difference between the Fermi energy EF and the intrinsic Fermi EI. An ideal MOS is defined as follows. At zero applied bias, the energy difference between the metal work function Q phi m and the semiconductor work function Q phi s is zero, or the metal work function difference Q phi ms is zero. Q phi ms is equal to Q phi m minus Q phi s is equal to Q phi m minus Q chi plus Eg by 2 plus Q chi psi b is equal to zero, where the sum of the three items in the brackets equals Q phi s. In other words, the energy band is flat, flat band condition where there is no applied voltage. B, the only charges that exist in the diode under any biasing conditions are those in the semiconductor and those with equal but opposite sign on the metal surface adjacent to the diode. There is no carrier transport throughout the diode under the direct current DC biasing conditions, or the resistivity of the oxide is infinite. This ideal MOS diode theory serves as a foundation for understanding practical MOS devices. When an ideal MOS diode is biased with positive or negative voltages, three cases may exist at the semiconductor surface. For the case of P-type semiconductor, when a negative voltage less than zero is applied to the metal plate, the excess positive carriers or holes will be induced at the silicon dioxide silicon interface. In this case, the bands near the semiconductor surface are bent upwards. For an ideal MOS diode, no current flows in the device regardless of the value of the applied voltage. Thus, the Fermi level in the semiconductor will remain constant. Previously, we determined that the carrier density in the semiconductor depends exponentially on the energy difference EI minus EF, that is PP is equal to NI e to the power of EI minus EF by KT. The upward bending of the energy band at the semiconductor surface causes an increase in the energy EI minus EF, therefore, which in turn gives rise to an enhanced concentration and accumulation of holes near the oxide semiconductor interface. This is called accumulation case. The corresponding charge distribution is shown on the right side, that is in this diagram, where Q is the positive charge per unit area in the semiconductor and QM is the negative charge per unit area. QM is equal to QS in the middle. When a small positive charge V is greater than 0 is applied to an ideal MOS diode, the energy bands near the semiconductor surface are bent upwards and the majority carrier holes are depleted. This is called the depletion case. The surface the space charge per unit area QSC in the semiconductor is equal to minus QNAW, where W is the width of the surface depletion region. When a larger positive voltage is applied, the energy bands bend downward, and even more so that the intrinsic level EI at the surface crosses over the Fermi level as shown in figure. This means the positive gate voltage starts to induce excess negative carriers electrons at the silicon dioxide silicon surface. The electron concentration in the semiconductor depends exponentially on the energy difference EF minus EI and is given by NP is equal to NI e to the power of EF minus EI by KT. In the case shown in figure, EF minus EI is greater than 0, therefore the electron concentration NP at the interface is larger than NI. The hole concentration is given by equation is less than NI. The number of electrons, the minority carriers at the surface is greater than holes, majority carriers. The surface is thus inverted. This is called inversion case. Initially, the surface is a weak inversion condition since the electron concentration is small. As the bands are bent further, eventually the conduction band edge comes close to the Fermi level. The onset of strong inversion occurs when the electron concentration near the silicon dioxide silicon interface is equal to the substrate doping level. After this point, most of the additional negative charges in the semiconductor consist of the charge Qn in a very narrow n-type inversion layer, X lying between 0 and Xi, where Xi is the width of the inversion region. Typically, the value of Xi ranges from 1 to 10 nanometers and is much always smaller than the surface depletion layer width. Once strong inversion occurs, the surface depletion layer width reaches a maximum. This is because when the bands are bent downward far enough for strong inversion to occur, even a very small increase in band bending corresponding to a very small increase in depletion layer width results in a large increase in the charge Qn in the inversion layer. Thus, under a strong inversion condition, the charge per unit area Qs in the semiconductor is the sum of the charge Qn in the inversion layer and charge Qsc in the depletion region. Qs is equal to Qn plus Qsc is equal to Qn minus Qna Wm, where Wm is the maximum width of the surface depletion region. A detailed band diagram at the surface of a p-type semiconductor, the electrostatic potential psi is defined as 0 in the bulk of the semiconductor. At the semiconductor surface, psi is equal to psi s. Psi s is called the surface potential. We can express the electron and hole concentrations as function of psi. Np is equal to ni e to the power of q psi minus psi b divided by kt. Vp is equal to ni e to the power of qp psi b minus psi by kt, where psi is positive when band is bent downward. At the surface, the densities are ns is equal to ni e to the power of q psi s minus psi b bracket close divided by kt, and ps is equal to ni e to the power of q in brackets psi b minus psi s bracket close by kt. From this discussion, with the help of the above equation, the following regions of surface potentials can be distinguished. When psi s is less than 0, accumulation of holes, bands bend upwards. Psi s is equal to 0, flat band condition. Psi b is greater than psi s is greater than 0, that is the depletion of holes, bands bend downward. When psi s is equal to psi b, this is called the mid gap, with ns is equal to np is equal to na intrinsic concentration. Psi s is greater than psi b, inversion bands bend downwards. The potential psi as a function of distance can be obtained by using one-dimensional Poisson equation. d square psi by dx square is equal to minus rho s x by epsilon s, where rho s x is the charge density per unit volume at position x and epsilon s in is the dielectric permittivity. We use the depletion approximation that we have employed in the study of p-n junctions. When the semiconductor is depleted to a width of W and the charge within the semiconductor is given by rho s is equal to minus q na, integration of Poisson's equation gives the electrostatic potential distribution as a function of distance x in the surface depletion region. Psi is equal to psi s in brackets 1 minus x by W to the power 2. The surface potential psi s is equal to q na W square divided to epsilon s. We note that the potential distribution is identical to that for a one-sided n plus p junction. The surface is inverted whenever psi s is larger than psi p. However, we need a criterion for the onset of a strong inversion after which the charges in the inversion layer becomes significant. A simple criterion is the electron concentration at the surface is equal to the substrate impurity concentration, that is ns equal to na, where na is equal to ni e to the power of q psi b by kt. We obtain psi s is equal to 2 psi b is equal to 2 kt by q ln na by ni. Equation states that a potential psi b is required to bend the energy bands down to the intrinsic condition at the surface ei is equal to ef, and the bands must be bent downward by another q psi b at the surface to obtain the condition of strong inversion. As we have discussed previously, the surface depletion layer reaches a maximum when the surface is strongly inverted. Accordingly, the maximum width of the surface depletion region Wm is given, in which psi s equals psi s inversion, or Wm is equal to under root of 2 epsilon s psi s divided by q na. This is nearly equal to under root of 2 epsilon s 2 psi b divided by q na. So Wm is equal to 2 under root of epsilon s kt ln in brackets na by ni divided by q square na. QSC is equal to minus QNA WM. This is nearly equal to minus under root of 2 QNA epsilon S into 2 psi B. So this is the equation for charge. Now we take an example. For an ideal metal silicon dioxide silicon diode having Na is equal to 10 to the power 17 per centimeter cube, calculate the maximum width of the surface depletion region. The solution is as follows. At room temperature, kT by Q is equal to 0.026 volts and Ni is equal to 9.65 into 10 to the power of 9 per centimeter cube. The dielectric permittivity of silicon is 11.9 into 8.85 into 10 to the power of minus 14 farad per centimeter. Wm is equal to 2 under root of 11.9 into 8.85 into 10 to the power of minus 14 into 0.026 ln. 10 to the power of 17 divided by 9.65 into 10 to the power of 9. Divided by 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 into 10 to the power of 17, this is equal to 10 to the power of minus 5 centimeter is equal to 0.1 micrometer. The relationship between Wm and the impurity concentration is shown for silicon and gallium arsenide, where Nb is equal to Na for p-type and Nd for a n-type semiconductor. Now we discuss the ideal MOS curves. The figure shows energy band diagram of an ideal MOS diode with band bending identical over here. In the absence of any work function, the applied voltage will appear partly across the oxide and partly across the semiconductor. So V is equal to V0 plus psi s, where V0 is the potential across the oxide and is given by V0 is equal to epsilon 0 d. This is equal to QSD divided by epsilon OX is equal to QS divided by C0, where E0 is the field in the oxide, QS is the charge per unit area in the semiconductor, and C0, epsilon 0 X divided by D is the oxide capacitance per unit area. The corresponding electrostatic potential distribution is shown in this figure over here. The total capacitance C of the MOS diode is a series combination of the oxide capacitance CO and the semiconductor depletion layer capacitance CJ. C is equal to C0 CJ divided by C0 plus CJ farad per centimeter square, where CJ is equal to epsilon S divided by W, the same for an abrupt p-n junction. we can eliminate W and obtain the formula for capacitance. C by C0 is equal to 1 divided by under root of 1 plus 2 epsilon square ox by Q Na epsilon S D square into V, which predicts that the capacitance will decrease with increasing metal plate voltage while the surface is being depleted. When the applied voltage is negative, there is no depletion region and we have an accumulation of holes at the semiconductor surface. As a result, the total capacitance is close to the oxide capacitance epsilon OX divided by D. In the other extreme, when strong inversion occurs, the width of the depletion region will not increase with a further increase in applied voltage. The condition takes place at a metal plate voltage that causes surface potential psi s to reach psi s inversion and given. Substituting psi s inversion and noting that corresponding charge per unit area is QNAWM yields the metal plate voltage at the onset of strong inversion. This voltage is called threshold voltage. So VT is given by QNAWM divided by C0 plus psi s. This is nearly equal to under root of 2